Hey, what's up, friends? Welcome to another episode of Dr. Sachin's podcast. This time, we are describing a disease called Kikuchi's lymphadenitis. And before starting with presentation, let's discuss the social buzz that went on Twitter this week. So this is podcast on Kikuchi's lymphadenitis, and social buzz this week was created by a British journalist called Piers Morgan. When he ridiculed India by this tweet, he said that country with 1.2 billion people wildly celebrates two losing medals, that is two losing silver medals. How embarrassing is that? And Twitter, Indian Twitterati, including the celebrity Virendra Sehwag, also countered him by various tweets. Virendra Sehwag said, "We cherish every small happiness, but England, who invented cricket, is yet to win a World Cup and still continues to play World Cup. Isn't that embarrassing?" So a lot of people countered Piers Morgan in various ways. It was a good Twitter fight. It was quite entertaining also. It was as if Piers Morgan was saying, "Hey Indians, you win only two medals. Your population is 1.2 billion. And here we are saying, hey Englishmen, you invented cricket and you never won a World Cup," and like that. It was quite entertaining. Now coming back to the serious business of pathology and Kikuchi's lymphadenitis. When I was a medical student, I had never heard of Kikuchi's lymphadenitis. What the heck is that? But when I joined pathology residency, I heard this diagnosis number of times. At least 2 to 3 cases every year were there reported as Kikuchi's lymphadenitis. Now let us see what this is about. Kikuchi's lymphadenopathy is a disease predominantly of young Asians. Cervical lymph nodes are commonly involved. There is mild fever occasionally, sore throat and myalgia, but course is benign and remission is spontaneous. Lymph node affected is most often unilateral and only slightly enlarged. Architecture is partially preserved. Characteristic feature of this condition is the patchy areas of necrosis. There is marked apoptosis, another characteristic, particularly of CD8 plus T cells, and nuclear debris are abundant. And that's the thing which should help us differentiate this necrosis from caseous necrosis that we get so frequently in India here. This condition also has aggregates of histiocytes, both phagocytic and non-phagocytic, with crescentic nuclei. Activated T lymphocytes, that is immunoblasts, are also present in abundance. Plasmacytoid monocytes are also seen. There is absence of neutrophils and eosinophils, another important characteristic. Histiocytes are of course CD68 positive and myeloperoxidase positive. B cells, which are few in number, are having CD20 positivity. T cells, which are the predominant cells, are having CD8 positivity. There are intracytoplasmic tubuloreticular structures which are associated with antiviral alpha interferon, and of course immunoblastic reaction is present. So this is in brief about Kikuchi's lymphadenitis, and now let us see one picture from web pathology showing the characteristics of this lymph node, this lymphadenopathy. To summarize, Kikuchi's lymphadenitis, also called necrotizing lymphadenitis, also called necrotizing histiocytic lymphadenitis, and also known as Kikuchi Fujimoto disease, is a self-limited disease of unknown etiology, usually seen in young women in Japan and in other Asian countries. Patients usually present with painless cervical lymphadenopathy that may be accompanied by fever. And lymph node shows well-circumscribed necrotizing lesions in paracortical areas. And we in India should be careful not to diagnose, not to mistake this disease as tuberculosis, which is a more predominant disease. And that's the importance of this disease. So this was it. This was a brief presentation this week. This is Dr. Sachin Kale signing out from his weekly podcast. See you again next time. Thank you.